preacher's in the house, but I think, boy, I tell you what, we might get out about midnight, that whole street moves in here tonight. I'm gonna tell you what, my God, if God gets you something, get up and get with it, it's all I can tell you today. Well, I tell you what, it's an honor for me tonight to introduce Bro.Charile Watkins. Tell you what, I haven't been acquainted with him all those many years, but there's just something about him there that first time I met him, that spirit.
Amen.
More witness for that spirit.
Yeah.
He's been here several times, and I've heard him testify, but I've never heard him preach. And I'm looking forward to it tonight. Bro.Charile, you just come.
Amen.
Let's preach to us what God's give you tonight.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
We thank God for the wonderful privilege of being able to be in His house again.
Amen.
Amen.
I'd rather be in the house of God any time than in the jail, hadn't you?
Amen.
Yeah.
I thank God that God gave me something one time to keep me out of jail.
Amen.
He gave me a love for Him and for my fellow man.
Yeah.
And I thank God that that love is. And I'll tell you this, it just works a whole lot better if you give it away.
Amen.
You know that?
Yeah.
It just works a whole lot better. But I thank God for His love and His mercy.
Amen.
That's followed us all down through time. His mercy is a flowing stream unto us. We could never, ever thank God enough for His wondrous love. Thank God that He saved me. 1943. You want to know how old I am? Yeah, I've been on this way for 73 years.
Amen.
So I thank God for it. But I'm just one of His little boys. Still, I'm still a learner, still going to school. But I thank God that He's a God that can learn.
Amen.
And we thank God for His presence. And for everyone that's here tonight,
amen.
I trust that we might be able to get something to you that will be a blessing.
Yeah.
That's why we're here. We're have this past week wrestled with different scriptures. And you know, sometimes we get in a place where we're twixt between. I don't like to get that way. It's hard. But we've settled on one thing, and I can't get nothing before you but what God seemingly has given me. But we do desire your prayers, and we thank God for His wondrous love. But if you that have your Bibles and desire to read with us, we want you to turn with us to the book of Mark, the Gospel of Mark, in the second chapter for our scripture reading this evening, and we'll try to get into the message pretty shortly, but the only thing that we can get before you tonight, and get with us on our reading. Start with us in the first verse, Mark chapter 2. And again he entered into Capernaum after some days, and it was noised that he was in the house. And straightway many were gathered together, inasmuch that there was no room to receive him, no, not so much as about the door. And he preached the word unto them. And they came unto him, bringing one sick of the palsy, which was born before. And when they could not come unto him for the press, they uncovered the roof where he was. And when they had broken up, they let him down, let down his bed, wherein the sick of the palsy lay. When Jesus saw their faith, he said unto the sick of the palsy, Son, thy sins be forgiven thee. Amen. If Kirk had read, that's reading five verses, and I feel that that's enough to get the thought before you tonight that we've got on our minds. And I pray that God's will be done here tonight. But you know, I love the church and I love God's people when they come together. I love to see them in one mind and in one accord. I love to see them in the manner that they've got the Spirit of God about them and are willing to take a stand for God Almighty. It's something that God left you. God left the church here for no other purpose but to carry on the work that our blessed Savior began to do and to teach when he was here. And that church was left here, my friend, to finish that work. My friend, it cannot be done in any other way but through the church of the living God. There's never been one that's ever been born again, but what, my friend, he come by the aid of the church of the living God. Beloved friend of mine, there's no other way that the gospel of the Lord Jesus Christ could ever be preached except through the church of the living God. A lot of people seem like, beloved friend of mine, they think the church very little. But I'll tell you something, she's a powerhouse for God when she works. Thank God. My friend, there's power in the church greater than any bomb that's ever failed. There's great arsenals, my friend, that's used to take the life of mankind. But I'm going to tell you something. When the power of God's working, there's nothing any stronger. Thank God for it. My friend, let me tell you something. There's a love in the church that man can't explain.
Amen.
And God can take that love, bless your heart, and do great wonders.
Yes,
everywhere that the Lord Jesus Christ gathered, there was somebody that was gathered to hear what he had to say. The sinners, the publicans, and the harlots, they love to be with Jesus. And I'm going to tell you, out of the abundance of the love of God, that's what the sinner wants today. There's lots of religions in this walk of life, but they don't want nothing to do with it. My friend, they ain't but one religion that God's pleased with. And he said this, to visit the widows and the orphans in their afflictions and keep yourself spotted from the world. Now that's religion. The rest of it is something man's got made of.
Man
ain't gonna work. But my friend, they ain't but one salvation. It's not of man, my friend. Man can't give it, but God can.
Yes, sir. Amen.
I thank God that 73 years ago, God marvelously saved my poor soul. I was just a little stripling, had nothing to offer God. God bless your soul. I knew, though I wanted what he had, but for my power, I couldn't attain to it. But I'll tell you, when Brother Jeff Baker laid down the gospel to me You know that place? It's just about a no man's land. But I love that place better than any place on God's earth. Because that's where God would get to live.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, man. Glory to God.
My own folks don't understand that.
Yeah, right.
And I'll tell you what, I can get back over there in the hills of Georgia, and bless God, I can shout hallelujah.
Sure. Amen.
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 Nothing like it.
Yeah.
That's right.
I was sitting about halfway back in the pews on the left side when Brother Baker began to preach to me. My friend, it seemed like he was laying it right down to where I was. And brother, let me tell you something. It had its effect.
Amen.
And I'll tell you what. When God got through with me that night, I could sing, "How Great Thou Art."
Yeah.
Yeah. God bless your soul. Because He was greatly and greatly to be praised.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
For what He done to me.
Yeah.
Brother, He gave me a life that was worth living.
Yeah.
Yeah. All the trouble that ever come this old boy's way. All the heartaches and persecution, and God bless you, seem like I had my part of them. Yeah. But I'll tell you something, they've been more joy than they have sadness.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
God give me something that night. Brother, let me tell you, that made this old boy want to be able to share it to somebody else.
Yeah,
let me tell you, there ain't nothing like it.
Oh, yeah.
This little boy sitting there, my little buddy, sitting there with me, the old boy by the name of Melvin Wooden. He was sitting there with me. Whenever God, for Christ's sake, forgive me of my sins, the very first thing I done, I went right back there where Melvin was and asked him about it.
Yeah.
Told him what God done for me.
Yeah. Yeah.
I wanted him to have the same thing. God, I want you, God bless your soul, to have what I've got.
Yeah.
Amen.
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 It can be. My friend, God loves the sinner. God, the church loves the sinner. And that, my friend, is something we're trying to work for. God bless you so by faith. Open your understanding to the love of my eternal God. My friend, let me tell you, the church is the only thing that God's got to work with in this walk of life. Them four little old men, God bless your soul, had enough love in their heart for their friend that they wanted him to know the God that he knew. He was sick. He needed help.
Yes.
And thank you, God.
Yes. Amen. Amen. Amen.
They just got him up. God bless your soul. He couldn't get to where Jesus was, but they carried him where he was.
Amen.
That is typical of the church.
Amen.
I did what they're supposed to do.
Amen.
The church can carry the lost to Jesus.
Amen.
My friend, not in person as far as carrying them, but in the spirit.
Amen.
I believe in God.
Amen.
You know, sometimes, beloved friend of mine, we get sort of down and out or something.
Sure.
That's something that, my friend, I don't like. But sometimes it happens. Old devil will get to working. First thing you know, he'll begin to make you wonder where you was and if they was any use. I say, get it behind me, Satan.
Amen.
It's all ahead of me.
Amen.
It's all waiting for me.
Yeah.
God, give me the start. God's going to give me the ending.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
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 Yes.
Amen. They won't be. You know what? I love to be able to love my fellow man and help him. I love to be able, my friend, to help the lost. I love to see them walk that aisle and come and make their peace calling and election sure with God.
Yes.
But my friend, I can say as Paul did, for me to live is Christ, but for me to die is gain.
Amen.
Brother, it's all over yonder, brother, right?
Right?
On the other side.
That's right.
It's a weight for me.
Yes,
I've got a title.
Amen.
I'm a friend to a mansion in glory.
Amen.
Amen.
This world is not my home.
That's right. That's right.
I'm just a
preacher.
My preacher. Arlena. Somewhere. Beyond.
Oh, yeah.
I've never been there. But I'm going with it. Thank God.
Oh, yeah.
Never mind. We sang the old-time religion. God bless your soul.
Yeah.
I thank my God that I lived in the golden age of the church.
Yeah.
I can tell you things that I witnessed when I was just a lad that most people can't do.
That's true.
Yeah.
I was talking to Brother Rob here the other day about us whenever we went to church. My only way that we had to go was in a two-horse wagon. I'll tell you, lots of times, them old whiskers on them old mules, the breath blowing out, our icicles would hang on to them.
Yes,
people love God.
Yes,
yes.
Why can't the church love God today?
Amen.
Brother Roy, my dad, I told Brother Rob this. You'll never see that. You won't know what this preacher knows. Mm. I've seen my daddy lay a big old rock up now on the hearth at the old fireplace. And he'd take that, he'd wrap it up good, lay it down in the bed of the wagon for my mother to set her feet on it to keep her warm. God bless your soul. But we went to church.
Yeah,
I'm praying to the other God.
Amen.
Yes.
That's right. Amen.
Oh.
I've seen the church. God bless your soul. I've seen the building. Beloved friends so full. There was no more seats. Brother, I'm sure you've seen some of that yourself. I've seen them standing in the windows. I've seen them standing in the door. God bless your soul. Didn't have room to sit down. But they stood there and they hear the gospel of a loving Savior that gave his life for them.
Amen.
Boys, it's a hard thing anymore to convince one to the altar.
Yes, that's right.
It's getting harder all the time.
Yeah.
But let me tell you something. I've witnessed in the church myself when I was a boy that even the sinners You can't get people today hardly to even testify.
Amen.
Come on.
But I've seen sinners rise and tell the congregation, I want you to pray for me. I'm lost. I want to be saved.
Amen.
But my friend, the church has just about done her work. She's just about ready to leave here. One day, I don't know when, but she's got to rise on the wings of love and go home with God.
Amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
But I still love that old song. We'll work till Jesus comes.
Right.
I love that. I'll tell you something. We ought to have a mind to work. After the Israelite people come out of 70 years of captivity and begin to build the temple of God and Jerusalem back, the Bible said they all had a mind to work.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Amen.
That's what gets the job done.
Yes.
That's what gets the gospel out. Amen. Is the work of the church.
Amen.
My friend, she's the greatest jewel that's ever been.
Yeah.
Amen.
I said this.
Amen.
People might not understand me, but I'll tell you on the authority of God's word and what I know about the church. I'm talking about the church,
Amen.
Not a congregation.
Amen.
I'm talking about people.
Amen.
That's been
yes,
church.
Amen.
But you know,
Amen. You
can have a congregation and not the old Billy church.
That's right.
Amen.
That's right.
All right.
You can have a congregation and no church.
That's right.
Yeah.
But bless God, the church is still here.
Amen.
Now, look, let me tell you something. By according to the word of God, brother, that Jerusalem, which is above, she's my mother.
Yeah.
The Bible said she's the mother of us all.
Yeah.
She's my mother.
Yeah.
And thank God for her.
Amen.
You won't find no fault in her. God bless your soul. We can make what we can find fault in our own self. If we live from one day to the next, there'll be something we need to repent of.
Yep.
And let me tell you something. God loves a repentant heart.
Oh, yeah.
And God will answer the prayers of a repentant people.
Yeah.
Amen.
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 I know.
That my Redeemer lives.
Amen.
Job said.
Oh, yeah.
Let me tell you something. That old boy had his mind on heaven.
Yeah.
He, my friend, he suffered for the cause of the Lord. Lost everything he ever had. The devil trying to shake him. But brother, he had an unshakable faith.
Yes.
Yeah.
Unshakable.
Amen.
He said, I know that my Redeemer liveth. Let me show you something. And he said, someday he will stand upon this earth. That was Jesus that he was talking about. He said, one day he shall stand on this earth.
Yeah.
He said, my eyes shall behold him and not another. My friend, them old saints of God, that the graves was open whenever Jesus, my friend, was crucified. And my friend, whenever he rose, my friend, they rose with him. And that fulfilled just exactly what Job said. He was in that congregation. God bless you so. How wonderful. He lived, my friend, for one purpose, and that is that his option would come.
Yes.
His desires would come true. My friend, there's nothing like it. So wonderful it is to be a child of the King.
Amen.
Praise God, folks. My friend, let me tell you, one day, I don't know. I may never, my friend, leave this walk of life till we all go together. That's right. I look for that. I live for it. I don't think nothing about, my friend, a short life or what days or nothing. I just live to be able to leave here and go home.
Amen.
Woo!
Amen.
That's going to be, you talking about amazing grace.
Amen.
That's
Amen.
When it begun.
Amen.
God bless you so. Nothing like it. Let me tell you something. There ain't nothing like what the amazing grace will do in you.
That's right.
He'll put a heart of love in you.
Yes.
God bless your soul. That though it'll even bring astonishment to the world.
Yes.
And I'm going to tell you something. If the church will live like it ought to, faithfulness to God, making things happen in the house of God, that they'll be astonished.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. They'll be coming around to see what's happening.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah. Amen.
I've seen revivals break out. My friend, whenever it was all said and done, they were the whole congregation to be baptized.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
So wonderful. All of them couldn't even get in the water at the same time. I heard a boy, heard somebody just this week talking about them being standing up on the banks and coming down and being baptized and going in. Brother, I've seen that.
Yeah.
It happened.
Amen.
Through the amazing grace of my God.
Amen.
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 Thank God. Let me tell you something. It'll house you, it'll shelter you in this walk of life, but it'll house you in eternity.
Yeah.
That's right.
Yes.
All of your heartaches that ever come your way, brother, he'll just merely put a smile on your face. That's right. You can stand in this life right in the devil's face. He's laughed enough at you. He's laughed enough at me. I'll tell you, there's got to be a time when he's got to get his dose.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
I'm looking forward to that
day. Yes.
Not that I believe in taking vengeance. I just leave that to the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
I don't have to stand and argue with the devil. I just tell him to get behind me.
Amen.
Just put my older brother on me. He'll take care of
me.
Business that we got, it wouldn't please them no more for everyone else to die. I'll tell you, they wouldn't have to be sorry in their heart and they wouldn't have to look at that man and say there's something different in him.
Yeah.
I'm glad I don't have nothing to do with it. The least I can have to do with the government, the better off I am. That's right. And I'm going to tell you something. The biggest trouble, the biggest mistake that dads and mother ever had is when I was just a little old tot. My friend and they was in the community. They was a school teacher that was teaching us. But let me tell you something. Through greed, through the desire to have more, through greed, my friend mothers and dads just turned their children over to the government and say, you educate them.
Yep.
We can't. That was the biggest mistake.
Amen.
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 Now,
look what we got.
The Supreme Justice in 1963, my friend, took everything away from the children, beloved friend of mine, what was any value to them.
Yep.
Yeah.
And that was God.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. You're right. God help.
I love, my friend. Now I'm going to tell this again. It's one most wonderful thing. It lives with me every day. It sleeps with me at night. And I'm so proud of it. I love to tell it. When we was going to school, little old school, I was going to the name of Dean Chapel in Alabama, northern Alabama, where I was born and raised. My friend, Miss Angelo, or Miss Winslow and Miss Hicks, was the teachers of that church. Right out in the yard, just joined the yard of the school. There was a Methodist church. About a quarter of a mile down the road, there was a Baptist church by the name of Happy Home. My wife has rode by with me a many times. She knows where it's at. And my friend, we spent our recess time, Miss Winslow and Miss Hicks, they lined us up, my friend, when the services started, and they marched us to the church. And they sat us down, and we listened to the preacher till the church was over.
Yeah,
and then we went back and took up books again.
Yeah.
Them teachers lives with me. Them teachers, my friend, helped mold me to the man I am today.
Amen.
What they done,
yeah,
and their willingness for the
Amen.
People
Amen.
To know God.
Amen.
Amen.
Helped mold me to the man I am.
Amen.
Amen.
I was going, after that, we moved away from where we was. And I'll tell you something. Them devotions in school then beats a lot of church services we have today.
Amen.
That's right. It's a whole lot, they was a whole lot better than some church services today because the power of God was felt in them. At the year I'm talking about, we had moved up. And I was going to Henninger, to the school there. And we always had our devotion. We never went to the church or anything, but we always had our devotion. My friend, you know what? Every soul, every household on God's creation that knows the way of God, they ought to have a they ought to have a devotional every night before they go to bed. Did you know it?
Yeah.
They ought to read God's word. If they don't do it, they ought to.
Yeah.
And they ought to talk to God before they press their pillow.
Yeah.
But I know people, and this ain't no hearsay, I know it's a fact. They profess to know God, but my friend, as the man of God said, in their heart they do lie. They don't never have time, my friend, ever to pick up the Bible and read it. They're so ignorant of God's word, and brother, you can't tell them nothing. They know more than I do, and they never read the word of God. My friend, it's a disaster to a home. It's a disaster to the children. It's a disaster to the wife. And it's a disaster to the husband. But I know one morning we was there in Henniger School. We was having our devotion. Like the hallway was here, the room I was in here, then there's a room joining us right like that, side by side. We was having our devotion. They was over there. My friend, they began to sing sweet, swing low, sweet chariot. I'm coming for to carry him. They was a little old brown, skinny, brown-headed girl, brown-eyed, just about that tall. My friend, whenever they said, swing low, sweet chariot, it's a coming for to carry me home. That girl broke out to shouting and shouting all over the I feel like to tell you, that's God.
Amen.
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 That's amazing grace.
Amen.
Brother, you just keep on singing. For my amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now
I see.
May God bless you. It's my prayer. Brother Roy, come and close out.
Bless you, Lord.
Whatever church you ask, you better pay attention to what went on here. What was preached there tonight? God's dealt with you tonight. You come. You get around this altar. You get around this altar. I don't know your name. I don't know your heart. I don't know. I don't know nothing. Only thing I know is what he's done for me. That's all I know. That's all I can testify to. But I'm headed you tonight. God is gracious and he is good. He won't ever leave you and he won't forsake you. Like Bro.Charile, it ain't nothing like serving Jesus. This ain't nothing like it. Can't nothing take the place of serving a holy God. Can't nothing take the place of that. Can't nothing take the feeling of that we have. Heard people say, boy, it'd be nice to go back and get saved again. That won't happen. Once you're saved, you're saved. I've never saved to the uttermost. Boy, I like that uttermost, don't you? Well, that tells me a lot. That uttermost tells me that it's far yonder, further than I can see. That's eternity. Do you know Jesus tonight? Do you really, really know him? If you don't, you need to get to know him before you leave this place. It's needs in this place tonight. It's needs in here. Everyone I was standing here, everyone I was, including me, we've got needs tonight. We've got burdens. We've got troubles. Every single one of us. Can I tell you, it ain't but one place we're going to find peace. It ain't but one place we're going to find help. And that's going to be through the Lord Jesus Christ. That's the only one that we're going to find help and peace from. He tells us in the book of John, chapter 14, verse 27, said, I'll give you a peace. I'll give you a peace. A peace, paraphrasing this place. A peace that only I can give you and man can't give you that peace.
Right.
Aren't you glad that he loved you enough? That he cleaned you up? You know, I like them stories where Jesus does something. He said, and immediately the lame would get up, walk. Immediately. Immediately the blind would see. You know what the message was? He was telling them, when you call on Jesus, immediately, immediately, he'll save you.
Amen.
Yeah.
John chapter 1, verse 7. 1 John says our faith will be tried by fire. Christian, don't you sit down on God. Don't you back up on God. You keep marching forward. You keep looking for the coming. You keep looking. You keep serving Him. You keep praising Him. You keep praying. You keep studying. You keep meditating upon God. Young people, don't you ever back up on God. Don't ever back up on Him. Because He ain't never backed up on you. And He won't ever. He'll never back up on you. Oh, we all stumble. We all fall. We all come short of the glory of God. We all do that. But you know something? He's always there. Oh, never forget before I say. I know every night the church had visited me so much, I knew every night what church was coming. I knew just about what time they would be there. Had an old sliding patio door, and I had that thing greased up so slick there you could look at it and nearly open itself. I'd hit that back door. I'd let them talk to the wife. And won't talk to them about that Jesus stuff. Oh, I thought I was high cotton. Doing what I wanted to do. Big old pine tree out there, and I'd take and show it to you today if they ain't cutting. I'd go hide behind that thing. And I'd peep around. I'd watch till they'd leave. Then I'd go back home. But you know, it took me a long time to ever realize Jesus behind that tree before I ever got there.
Amen. Amen.
Get behind that tree before I ever got there. Messed up. Oh, was the house gone one day? Sit on this side of the church, back seat, outside. Don't show you, same pew still there. Carl McNeil, some of y'all know him, preaching. He wasn't rowdy. He wasn't like some of the rest of us. Just kind of calm. He'd get to preaching, he'd get to pulling. That finger got worse than Pinocchio's nose. It just got longer. Every time he'd point it out, wasn't nobody in there but me, I know, because that finger was pointing at me every time he'd point.
Amen.
I said, boy, I wish he'd shut up. I said, I got to get out of here. I wish he'd hush. Tired of listening to this. Hush. He hadn't been preaching about 5 minutes. There a wrestle, fought with God. Finally, give him the invitation. Oh, when I stood up, I grabbed that pew in the front of me and I wouldn't turn that thing loose for nothing. I had a death grip on it. The church had caught on fire. I just carried the pew with me because I wasn't going to turn it loose. So I don't know what happened. Something happened from there to here that I can't recollect. I don't know what happened. I don't know how I turned loose that pew. I don't know where somebody knocked me loose or what. I don't know. But I sure know what happened when I got long in here, though. I know what happened then. I met a living God. Oh, I met a Savior. Oh, I stumbled and failed. Hurt my back up on him a lot of times. He's behind that tree. He's been behind everywhere that I've been. Got dealing with me about calling me to preach. I said, God, you made the biggest mistake you've ever made in your life. Had to give that up too. Whatever he's dealing with you about tonight, you're going to have to give it up. You'll give it up sooner or later. You'll give it up. You can't hold on to it forever. Boy, good, isn't he?
Amen.
Oh, didn't you enjoy it for the church?
Oh, yes. Yes.
Yes. Yeah, man. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Oh, I tell you what, 8 minutes left.
That's right.
That stood the test of time. 8 minutes left. But boy, I'm glad we still got a few young ones that's coming along and tell us like it is. Brother Eller, I'm proud of you.
Amen.
Keep on hammering. You keep on hammering that gospel.
Amen.
You keep on hammering it in the pulpit. That's what we need in this day and hour. We need them that will stand and not back up on the word of God.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Lord, I got to hush. I just got to brag on Jesus a little bit.
Amen.
Good heaven. Woo! He's so good to us.
Yes.
Woo! Might be anything, anybody. Brother Leonard, got anything on your heart?
I just thank God.
Oh, we got plenty of time.
Thank God to hear the man of God tonight.
Amen.
Tell a story of yesteryear. The power of the church revival. My generation hasn't seen that.
Amen.
My generation longs for it. I do.
Amen.
But the Bible still says, blessed are they which hunger and thirst after righteousness. Shall be filled.
Amen.
No, I still believe in revival. I still believe that God can.
Amen.
Until we see it, we're just going to keep praying. But I hope to see it as He saw it. I thank God for Brother Charlie. Thank God for it. What a blessing He is. Amen.
I can relate. I can remember going to church in a two-horse wagon. But we had a pair of you and a John Deere wagon. I won't ever forget it. Steel wheels on a gravel road.
Wow.
I still remember that. Church in our community was Methodist church. You couldn't tell the difference in the Methodist, the Baptist, or whatever it was. Me and this got behind God's sacred desk and just preached God's word.
Yeah, man.
Just preached the glory to God.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember them. I'd take you to the church. Windows was raised, people standing outside, their heads stuck in the window. I remember that. I was small, but I remember that. Remember ladies get to shouting and babies laying in the floor and them get to routing and shouting and running. Never touch a baby. Never touch a baby. That's God. That's God. It's just God.
To see it again.
Might be anything for anybody else, sir. I'm
hurt. I remember all that too, because I'm older than him. I'm 77. And I remember we used to go in the, with me with the wagon, sit in our wagon, all cotton. We'd pick cotton and go get we sent away, and we had like a, what you call a tent now, it was more like something that mama made, you know, to go with the wagon covered, and we go to the grocery store, one of us boys would go to the drive, she'd set up in there, and she'd go in to get her groceries, have a seat across it where she'd sit. And like he was talking about, if it was cold, you know, my dad would have his pick for that, mama's seat would be on the warm block, trying to keep her feet warm to her shoes. It was fresh for the kids, but we just had to tuck it out. And I drove mama a million times, and me and her took those others when I drove. Now, the National Trace State Park is the road you know up there.
If you had a top on that wagon, you had a Cadillac. Yes, ma'am.
I have a request. I would like the church to pray for my son. I want to stand in for him. He's been on drugs, alcohol, in and out of jail. He doesn't know God. He's lost. He thinks the whole world's against him. And he has wanted to commit suicide a number of times. And he needs the Lord.
Amen.
And I prayed for him for years and years. And I heard from him today, first time I heard from him in a long time. And he told me he would go to church Sunday morning. And that's God.
Amen.
And I have faith enough to believe that God's going to save him.
Amen. Keep praying, sister.
Because he can do anything. He's all powerful. And he sure needs the Lord. And he needs people to help him. Support him and get him free. He's going to be staying with me and my daughter for a while. And he's coming up here with no job, no money, no nothing. And he really needs church people. He needs help. He needs somebody to just love him and show him that there is a God. Because he truly is a sinner. And he knows he is, and he doesn't know how to get to God. He don't understand.
Amen. 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 We need to remember this lady too. She's going to have some major surgery, I think, at the end of the month. So we certainly need
that surgery is nothing compared to
them. Amen.
She's
getting around, folks. Let's pray for her. Pray for this boy here. Let's pray for this boy now. God, let's move in. Holy Spirit of God, there at this word. Hey, God can find him wherever he's at.
Yeah.
Don't make no difference where it is. God can find him. And I tell you what, I don't know his name, but God knows. God knows all about him. And we just lift him up to God. Amen. Oh, dear God. Lord, we just come, Lord, to you, Father, God, Lord Jesus. Lord, we just come to you, Lord, you can be saved. God, we lift our son up, Lord. Lord, we know you're at the Lord, God, you can do all things. Father, we know you have all this good God, and go to the vision of the Savior, God.
God's son, God saved
or whatever I'm behind, God, he might be here. Lord, we got the Holy Spirit.
Devil, you get off that boy. Get away from that boy. That's God's child.
Lord,
we pray.
Believe it. Get away from him. Pray God,
Lord,
and
you church, that the church will welcome you, Lord.
Now give her strength, God.
Yes.
And oh God, she's going through the surgery. Lord, just bring her there. And we'll thank you. We'll praise you for it.
Yes.
In Jesus' name. God, we love you so much tonight. In Jesus' name.
Yes.
And we're trusting you, Lord, for all things.
Yes.
Lord, you tell us whatsoever we shall ask, believe in, Lord, that you do. Lord, we believe tonight.
Yes.
Lord, we believe. We believe. That you can and you will tonight.
Yes.
In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Amen. Hey, Mom and Daddy's used to get concerned. Used to get in trouble. Get praying for the young ones. They get back to praying. Get back to it. Anything, anybody else?
Boy, if I might just say this.
Yes, sir.
No, I'm glad. I love to be carried back. He carried up here and said, remembrance.
Yeah.
I'm glad that remembrance is still serving at today's call.
Amen.
Amen.
We just got to get on our heart and mind and realize God can do the same thing.
Yes, amen.
The church can still be what it ought to be.
Amen.
It's not because God is moved. It's not because God has lost his power. It's not because God has changed.
Come on.
That is the night it's called for you.
Amen. That's right.
I remember those glorious times. Boy, I'm glad that he's still real tonight.
Amen.
I'm glad he's still real, buddy. Do we want it?
Yes,
yeah. Yeah.
Yeah,
that's right.
It's not up to God. It's up to us.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
It's
yeah.
up to us. Honey, we can have stories. If God carries this thing, let this thing go another 50 years, we can have some stories to tell.
Amen. Yeah.
Brother Rob said he hungers for his generation, his yeah. children yeah. to see. Yeah. Honey, God can do it.
Yeah.
If we don't watch yeah. tonight, these old churches yeah. will be closed.
That's
so
right.
Sweetheart.
Right.
There ain't going to be nothing to tell except for somewhere underground.
Yeah.
Honey, tonight I'll tell you something. We need to stay abroad telling
them. Amen. Amen.
The bad times. Honey, well, he preached about yeah. some good things. Honey, don't go home and think about, boy, I wish that was back then. I wish I had back then. Honey, we serve the same God
yeah.
tonight.
Yeah. 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 Yes, we do.
Amen. I'm glad, honey, we will get just right. We get
yeah.
some of it.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Honey, don't think that, honey, that was just about yesterday.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
We ain't got to get him like an old car and fix him up and make him look good for good again. Honey, Jesus is still the same.
Yeah. Yeah.
We ain't got no wax solution yes. about this. Honey, we ain't got nothing. You got to have some real wax to bring something new, you know? Honey, God don't need no shining up.
Amen.
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 Well, I sit here thinking, God, it's all my fault.
Yeah.
God, it's my fault. We don't sing in the Spirit. We don't pray in the Spirit. We don't testify in the Spirit. We don't do nothing with the Spirit, Brother Charlie.
Yeah.
Honey, one person shouted tonight. We ought to have been praising the Lord all the
time. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I enjoyed it tonight. Boy, I'm glad I'm here. I'm glad I'm here tonight. Boy, I enjoyed it tonight. I do remember. I do remember.
Amen.
I remember old saints getting sleazy, used to call it being slew under the Spirit.
Yeah.
Honey fell out of the floor shouting yeah. praises yeah. of God. Yeah. People preaching three or four preachers at one time. Yeah. Honey, they can't do it now because they gotta read their notes, honey. They gonna
yeah.
go.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
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 Yeah. You say, well, preacher, I don't like that. I ain't here. I didn't speak because you want me to. Honey, I tell you, this thing is real. What Brother Charles and saying it from here and saying it from
yes,
the heart.
Amen.
Give me for taking so much time. Honey, I tell you, this ain't real what he preached
amen.
About.
Oh, yeah.
Boy, I tell you, I yeah. used to hear it from my dad. He's been gone 20 years. I'm still hearing it, and I want to keep telling it.
Amen.
Amen. I do. I want my son to tell it. He's younger than Brother Rob back there just about 4 or 5 years. I want him to know about it to tell it.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
So let's go tell somebody.
Yeah, amen. Amen.
Forget before we get out of the house of God.
Yes.
Amen.
But before we leave here, somebody be talking about hunting.
Yeah.
Somebody be talking about wanting to go fish.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen.
And the message in the church service is done dead and gone.
Yes, sir.
You're right.
Yeah. Used to, it was still alive. Folks be shouting on Tuesday. What happened on Sunday?
Yeah. Amen.
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 Well, Lord.
Yeah, man.
I wish I had a preacher tonight. Amen.
Yeah, man.
Quit telling the truth.
I'll shout on the way home.
Amen.
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 Amen. Well, I tell you what, this week has been good.
Yeah.
It's been good for the church.
Yeah. Yes. And Brother Ron, maybe you'll know it every night.
Yep.
Amen.
Man, that's good right there. You know, Brother Eller, I'm with you, brother. I still believe in you. And I'm still, I wasn't in church back then. Wasn't born back then, but I've heard some good stories tonight. I've heard some good truth tonight. No stories.
True. Amen.
And I'm still hungry for it.
Oh, yeah.
I believe in the great revival is still yet to come.
I believe.
But if we don't get out there and start telling people, he's right about the church. I hate to say it, he's right. I ain't been to church long, but I've seen some good churches, and I've seen some pretty dead churches. And the people are hungry for it. The reason why they ain't in here, because we ain't out there. I mean, I'm guilty. I'm not stepping on no one's toes but myself.
I say people's hungry for the truth.
People are hungry for the truth. Not a word, they're hungry for the truth. I believe that the windows can be opened and people be poured out. I believe that still. I still believe it. I still believe there's a hunger out there. And there's a burden for the lost. There should be a burden on all our hearts.
Amen.
You know, we should be, I'm happy to see new faces in the church. I've been so busy, I ain't been here in a bit. And I've seen some new faces, but you know what? The regulars are not here, so you know what's going on. You know? But it's all right, because we need new faces. We need a lot of faces. But yeah, I'm hungry for that revival. I know people, I get excited. I wouldn't have missed tonight for the world. I don't know, he might go home, we all might go home tonight. And I might not ever get to hear that, man. I'm blessed. I'll go home changed tonight. Changed and hungry for the church again. I revived in my soul. I've been here one night, but it revived my soul. And I'm hungry, and I'm waiting for that revival too. And I'm going to be standing in the gap when it comes.
Amen.
And I'm going to try to do my best in the meantime.
Amen.
Be a worker for the Lord.
Amen.
Get excited about God in our new year.
Amen.
I got instant pain. I worked 13 and a half hours today, but guess what I did? I went home, got cleaned up, and came and saw the Lord.
Amen.
God is so good.
Amen. Yeah.
Amen.
Song leader, I got a suggestion. Sunday morning, let's sing about, are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? But instead of washed, let's put, are you sprinkled in the blood of the Lamb? That's right. Amen. Amen. All hearts and minds clear.
Glory to God.
Lord, why you dismiss us tonight? We please.
Lord, just thank you so much, Lord, tonight. Your son, Jesus.